Hi friends, I am Manmad Krishna. You are watching Manmad Krishna Food Tech channel. In this video, we will discuss about how to quantify the glazing percentage in IQ frozen streams. So this video comprises, first we will discuss what are the equipments required for to measure the glazing percentage, what are the methodologies available globally to quantify the glazing percentage of streams, and what are the difficulties faced by the seafood industries to maintain consistent glaze in IKF frozen shrimps during freezing or during processing. Let us start the video. Now let us discuss about international methods used to quantify the glazing percentage in IKF frozen shrimps. What are the methods available to measure the glazing percentage in IKF frozen shrimps? So there are two methods. One is the Codex method to determine the glazing percentage in IKF frozen. The second one is AYSC or NIST method. Association of Analytical Chemists or National Institute of Standards and technology. Now we will discuss about the Codex method. What the Codex method says to check the deglazed weight of the shrimps. To quantify the glazing percentage in IQ frozen shrimps, first we need the equipments. Equipments like we need the balance and weights. Weights means the calibrated weight and receiving pan and drain massive is like 8 massive in AOSC method. The 8 massive amended to 12 inch massive. So 12 inch dia massive is advisable whenever if you check the quantify the glazing percentage of more than 1 lb of the IQ frozen shrimps. Below 1 lb of IQ frozen shrimps, mesh dia should be 8 inch massive is enough. Whereas more than 1 lb, mostly we people are doing 2 lbs to check the glazing percentage of the shrimps. 2 lb we are taking. So the dia also we require the 12 inch dia. And the mesh size also, the mesh size and water temperature, the factors to determine the quantify the glazing percentage are water temperature should be, and the sieve mesh size, and what should be the sieve slopes, the contact method, contact time, and drainage time. See, when you see the Codex method tells us the water temperature should be the ambient water temperature. It means the water temperature generally 24 degrees centigrade or 25, 26 degrees centigrade, like that. So up to maximum maybe 30. So the ambient water temperature we have to maintain. And the mesh, sieve mesh size also, whether you use SS mesh sieve or you use plastic mesh sieves, the size should be 2.8 mm and 12 inch dia. So the massive size and slope, once you deglaze the slabs, once you feel that the glaze melted, the ice glaze has been removed, once you feel, then you have to put the sleeve in 20 degree angle, means slight slanting position, 20 degree angle. Then the Codex method also says that contact method is the immersion in the ambient water, and contact time also until all ice glaze removed, so we can identify the ice has removed or not. We should not thaw the shrimps. Drainage period also 120 seconds, means 2 minutes. Whereas AOSC or NIST method, NIST method, let's have a look. NIST method says that cold water is required. Cold water means running cold water, NIST or AOSC method. Running cold water 2.8 mm or 12 inch dia massive, and the angle after melting the ice, the drainer also we have to keep in 17 to 20 degree angle. This is contact method is the spraying. So we have to spray the shrimps. We have to spray the IQ frozen shrimps with chilled water. IQ frozen with chilled water. And the contact time is until all ice glaze is removed. That is the contact time. And 120 seconds is the drainage time. this is the procedures. So after 120 seconds, we have to transfer the material into the receiving pan. So once we transfer the material into the receiving pan, already we have tested the weight of the receiving pan, then we will take the weight. Then you all knows how to quantify the glazing percentage. Yes, the frozen weight minus deglazed weight by frozen weight into 100, it will gives us the glazing percentage of the shrimps. Based on that, we will give the filling weight for online package. Based on these international methods to quantify the glazing percentage, we can validate our internal purpose. AVC method says that the cold water should spray. We can modify as per our convenience, and we have to validate the methods compared with these things, the study. India, most of the factories are following 20 to 24 degrees centigrade of the water temperature to deglaze the shrimps at a temperature of 20 to 24 degrees centigrade. And these are all say massive size or round mesh like plastic drain. They are using 12 inch dia, that is okay. And the angle of slanting also, we have to ensure that 20 degree angle. The spraying, we can use immersion method to minimize the wastage of water. Now, do's and don'ts in IQF frozen glazed shrimps quantification procedure. What are the things to be done? What are the things should not to be done? Things to be done. The first one is always choose a circular sieve or circular net 8 inch to drain the 1 lb of IQF frozen shrimps. Whereas always choose circular drain net with 12 inch dia to deglaze for 2 lb IQF frozen shrimps. That is the first one. And the second one, before start of the operation, you should calibrate the balance with weighing stones. Calibrate the weighing stones. Then the third thing we must do is, after deglazing, we have to drain out the water in a 20 degree angle. Yes. And the fourth point is, during deglazing of IQF frozen shrimps, the temperature should be at 20 to 24 in between. We have to maintain and agitate the shrimps gently. We have to agitate the shrimps in a circular 12 inch dia net. Do's, we should have the stopper to check the deglazed weight. So 120 seconds, based on the stopper we have to follow. And what are the don'ts? The first, deglazing should not be done in a rectangular or square type net or drainer. Why? Because while doing gentle agitation, the material won't properly stir and the melting of ice also won't properly occur. Always stir in a circular net with 12 inch dia. That is the first one. And the second one is, after deglazing or after draining out, most of the people, they are pressing the material shrimps to remove the excess water. We should not do that. We should not press the material to remove the excess water. The second one. And the third one also, after draining, we should not shake the net to remove the excess water. That is also we should not. And the last step is, while deglazing, we should not thaw the shrimps. We have to stop once you feel all ice becomes melted or all ice removed from the product, then immediately we have to stop. That's all about the video. I made this video into two parts. The part one is completed. And part two, we will discuss about how to maintain consistent glaze during IQ freezing of students. How to maintain consistent glaze weight. So in our part two video, we will discuss. Please stay tuned. If you like the video, click the bell icon and subscribe my channel for regular updates. Thank you. Bye-bye.